Hello guys, good morning. Welcome back to a new video. A very cold morning here. So in this video I have a Cisco Nexus N5K. It doesn't boot. As we can see right here, you know, the unit only boot into the loader. So basically, let me reboot the unit just to make sure, to show you basically that the unit doesn't boot. This, you know, maybe, you know, missing operating system. There is no operating system actually, because when I execute their boot flash, it doesn't show anything. So maybe, you know, somebody format the boot flash memory, and that is the reason why it's not booting. So I will show you a procedure how to recover, you know, the operating system, you know, from the network. That's the only way to recover this guy, you know, through the network. You know, copy the kickstart image and the system image from a TFTP server. So we are going to assign, you know, IP parameters to the management interface, and then from there, you know, we are basically, you know, copy first, you know, the kickstart image, booting basically using the kickstart image from the TFTP server. Once it's there, we need to load the system image, and after that we need to, you know, install the boot image, you know. It's a single command: install all kickstart boot flash, the name of the file, system, and the name of the file. This will, you know, basically, you know, install the operating system. We'll do some upgrades onto the BIOS as well, and then after that, you know, we need to modify the boot variables. So let's start doing that. So basically, we are going to assign an IP address, set IP binary 2.168.0.178.255.255.255.0. Enter. So now I need to the name of the kickstart image. I have it somewhere here. There we go. So this is the kickstart image right there. Minimize that. And then boot TFTP 192.168.0.102. My server and the file name. So enter. This will take, you know, a couple of minutes maybe. Let's start doing that. So as we can see right here, you know, the image start responding and executing the install process. After here, you know, the next step is assign another, I mean, the same IP address or different IP address to the management interface, and from there copy a boot image, the kickstart image, and the system image to boot flash. So let's wait until this is ready. So you know where the boot, so we are going to enter into the configuration mode, interface, MGMT interface, MGMT 0 IP address 192.168.0.178.255.255.255.0. Not shut down. Okay, now we need to copy, you know, boot image to boot flash. Exit from here. And so now we need to copy TFTP to boot flash. So we need to copy first, you know, whatever. I mean, it doesn't really matter the order of the image, but file name, the kickstart image, of course. This one is a small file. The system image is, you know, a little, you know, a bigger file, so it will take maybe like a 10 minutes. But that's the only choice that we have. So 192.168.0.102. Okay, this will take, you know, maybe 2 or 3 minutes, depending of the size of the file. So we can see right here, the copy process is complete. The first image, right? This is two different images. So let's copy the other, the system image. This will take a little longer because it's a bigger file. Paste. So that's the file name. And enter. 192.168.0.102. Enter. And let's wait until the process is complete. This takes like a maybe 10 minutes, okay? Let's wait until the process, the copy process. And after that, you know, we are going to go to the next step, you know, in order to recover the Nexus switch. So look at here, you know, the copy is complete. Now we need to go to load the system image. So let's go load bootfresh. Paste and enter. This will basically, you know, mount the system image, and after that, we are able, you know, to perform the install process, which is just a single command on which you install, you know, the two, the kickstart and system image. Let's wait until, you know, all the process is complete. So the system image already loaded. Just let's abort this process. We need to answer yes here. And after that, we need to assign, you know, a password for the user admin. Right there. We can cancel this process right here. So admin. Right there, show version. Now we need to install the image. So basically we need to go install or kickstart, bootflash, and the file name, which is this one right here. Copy, paste, system image, right? Bootflash, and the system image, which is this one right here. So this will take, you know, like about maybe 3-4 minutes. And this process will upgrade, if needed, of course, the BIOS version. Let's enter here. There we go. It is verifying both images, of course, that the image basically is not corrupted. Everything is going well. So look at here, you know, the upgrade process determined that it's not, the BIOS upgrade is not necessary. Look at that. So basically we just need to go continue the installation, yes. Enter. You know, right now it's sharing the boot variables right here. And you know, the performing configuration copy, basically. So let's right there. So basically it's done. So we need to go into the configuration. Let's check something. Show boot bar. Show run. So, you know, the boot variables are right here already, so I don't really need to, you know, to enter into the configuration mode and declare, you know, the boot variables. So basically, that will be all. So show Well, the we need to basically reload the unit to make sure that everything is working fine. Let's reload the unit, and then after that, you know, we are going to run a few diagnostic commands just to make sure that all components on the switch are working properly. Reload. Yes, enter. So let's play, right? So the unit already boot. Let's check. Admin. Admin and password. Show version. That's the version right there. So look at that. This is the kickstart image and the system image. Show models. Right there. So we have another 12-port 10 gigabit. The power is up, right? And this is basically the switch. The supervisor, basically. Show inventory. Okay, show environment. Everything looks normal to me, you know, all FEMs are working properly, right? Power supply as well. And, you know, there is not, you know, overheating on the unit, nothing like that. So basically, let's check, show license host ID. And since there were not, you know, any operating system, I assume that somebody format the boot flight, so there is no license. Show license usage. Yep, so basically, guys, that is how did you recover a Cisco Nexus N5K from the lower prompt. Thank you so much for your time, I really appreciate it. Please, if you like the video, give me a like, subscribe to my channel, and share with your friends and co-workers. Thank you so much, and have a great day. I will see you in the next video. Thank you.